Dear students, welcome back to a new session. So today's topic is shark. Okay, since we have finished first unit, in second unit we are dealing with fishes and species. We have seen the general characters and classification. In that, the type study it is given for you all is shark. Shark is also called as dogfish or scoliodon. Okay, now coming to its classification. Shark belongs to phylum Chordata, subphylum Vertebrata, subclass Species, and class Chondrichthyes, and also common name is Soracoa. Okay, Soracoa. So now coming to its distribution and also habit and habitat. Sharks, as I told you all, sharks are also called as dogfishes. These are distributed in Indian, Pacific, South America and Atlantic oceans, and also along the eastern coasts also. Now coming to this shark habit and habitat. Shark has an elongated snout and depressed head and compressed body. Okay, so this shark are marine and carnivorous fish feeding on crabs, worms and other smaller fishes. So in case of shark, sexes are separate, and if you see here, these are viviparous giving birth to young ones. Coming to its external features of shark. External features, if we can see, the first one is body, fins and eyes. Now coming to this external features, if you see here the body is elongated. As I told you, body is elongated and spindle shaped, and it is compressed, and the body color will be in gray color on the dorsal half and tail yellowish color on the ventral part. So when the shark is fully grown, it measures about 60 centimeters in length. So this body is further divided into fins. Okay, the fins are nothing but they are flap like outgrowths from the body wall, and these are cartilaginous and horny fin rays. These fins are again of two types. Those are paired fins and unpaired fins. What are paired fins? Paired fins are these are attached ventrolaterally together in the trunk region. Okay, and the unpaired fins are unpaired fins are called as median fins, and these are present from the dorsal, ventral and to the caudal area. That means in about from the middle of the body like a lion. Okay, now coming to eyes. A pair of eyes on either side of the head, on the lateral side, is present for shark. Eyelids are the outgrowths of the skin itself, and it is having a thin transparent nictitating membrane which is present all over the eye for the sight purpose. Next, if you see body apertures, what are the different apertures it is having? Mouth, nostrils, gill slits, cloacal aperture. Now coming to mouth. Mouth is transverse slit like opening present on the ventral side. Okay, nostrils are anterior to the mouth on the ventral side of the body, and these nostrils perform the function of olfactory function, and also they do not open into the mouth, and hence there is no respiratory function. Gill slits, if you see behind the eyes to each pectoral fin, there are present. These are called as external gill slits. And next one is cloacal aperture. At the root of the tail, that means near the tailed caudal fin area, between the two pelvic fins, cloacal aperture is present. It leads into a small chamber called as cloaca, and which is digestive and urinogenital systems for them. Okay, now coming to its integument or skin of scoliodon or shark or dogfish. Integument is nothing but the skin of the shark. So sharks, as I told you all, these are exclusively marine organisms and cosmopolitan distribution. They are swift swimmers. That means swift means very fast swimming and predatory animals and also attackers. They are good attackers. They attack all the small fishes, crabs, worms, anything. And also the skin is itself is a tough covered with different layers of layers present, that is epidermis and dermis. So the skin is divided into outer ectodermal or epidermis, inner mesodermal or dermis. So this epidermis is made up of many layers with stratified epithelial cells, and the inner most basal layer of the epidermis is of possessing the columellar cells. Okay, now the next layer is dermis. If you see, dermis develops from the mesoderm of the embryo. It consists of connective tissue with white fibers, smooth muscles and pigment cells and nerves. So this dermis also helps as an pigment for the dark color which is present on the dorsal side of the fish body. Okay, now what is the functions of the skin? Okay, why this protective layer is there? What is function? How it protects? It acts as a protective layer to the internal organs against any injuries, and also mucus secreted by the mucus glands will reduce friction and also prevent any other microorganisms to enter into the body. Slippery nature of the skin protects the animal from predators. And also, as I told, it is having receptor pigment cells in the skin which detect the changes in the surroundings and also help in reacting the animal to the particular environment or surrounding. This is the functions. Now, coming to the exoskeleton of shark. Exoskeleton in shark or dogfish or scoliodon is of very important, and it is formed of very minute, hard, tooth-like dentricles in shape, and they are placed in a rows, oblique rows. So the main exoskeleton of shark is placoid scales, the scales which are present. If you see a close observation of a shark with a like if you dissect and see, you can see this and see under a microscope, you can see this scale shape that is called as a placoid scales. So if you see here, this placoid scales is very important, and it is having a very peculiar structure. If this is a basal plate, and this is a median spine, and this is a lateral spine, and this is a pulp cavity. This is both are same. This is the one side what I have drawn. This is the pulp cavity, which helps, that means from the pulp of the cavity give the required secretions, which helps the exoskeleton to be always nourished and protect the body against any other injuries. So this is about placoid scales. In the next session, we will learn about digestive system of shark. Thank you.